What's the matter?
We're surrounded. I see four of them.
We've got company. It's the Ocelot unit. Let's get out of here. Hurry! Don't forget your gear. Here, give me a hand. We can use this to get to the basement. I'll get past them on my bike. I'll call you later.
Okay. I'll keep them busy. Huh?
Don't go dying on me now.
Thank you. I've been waiting for this moment. That's it! That's the stance! I don't think so. What? A female spy? This bitch is wearing perfume. Stay where you are. I've had enough of your judo.
I see you've got yourself a single-action army.
That's right. There'll be no accidents this time.
You call that an accident? Well, it wouldn't have happened if you hadn't been showing off.
What did you say?
It's a nice gun, I'll give you that. But the engraving gives you no tactical advantage whatsoever. Unless you were planning to auction it off as a collector's item. And you're forgetting one more very basic thing. You don't have what it takes to kill me.
We'll see.
That thing only carries 6 shots. The Makarov carries 8. You have to get a feel for how many you have left. This is a high-class weapon. It's not meant for shooting people.
This isn't over yet.
Don't.
Why?
He's still young.
You'll regret stopping me. Damn it! I've got to get back before he does.
Saving the game, Snake?
Snake, have you seen Earth versus the Spider?
Nope.
It's about this spider that suddenly mutates into a giant monster. They bring it into the city in a state of hibernation, but it wakes up and starts wrecking the place.
So why did the spider turn huge?
I told you, it suddenly mutated.
Yeah, right.
Snake, it's people like you that take all the fun out of watching movies. Always nitpicking and taking things too seriously. Honestly, why even bother? Look, the important thing isn't that it got big.
Then what is important?
The fact that there's a huge spider destroying the city. Suspend your disbelief. That's the whole point of movies. Snake, are you there?
Eva?
Did you miss me?
Did you make it without any trouble?
No one saw me.
So you're back with Vulgan?
In a matter of speaking.
What about the boss?
Yeah, she's here too.
Better be careful.
Thanks, I will. The boss and I get along pretty well, though. I guess we traitors have a lot in common.
Why would anyone want to defect? Betraying your country like that, I just don't get it.
Are you talking about the boss?
Why do you do it? Weren't you born and raised in America?
Yes, in a small rural town. I never even knew there were other countries, other cultures, other ways of thinking, until I went to work for the NSA. And one day, I found I'd lost faith in the things I'd been taking for granted.
What did you see? What was it that made you want to change sides?
You wouldn't believe me if I told you.
Try me.
I saw the universe.
The universe?
Not the actual universe. The universe as the intelligence community sees it. I realized that the gravity in this universe was holding me back. That's all. People and countries are both changed by their environment. And by the times.
That sounds like what the boss was saying.
There's a world of difference between this country and America. But it's only a difference of position, a difference of perspective. Coming here made me realize something. Half of what I'd been told was a complete and utter lie. The other half was a conveniently constructed lie.
Where's the truth, then?
It's hidden in the lies.
Are you lying, too?
Who knows? I've been trained to make even the most severe falsehood sound like the honest truth. Weren't you?
No. I believe because I have to, even if it is a lie. That's part of my mission.
I'll have to remember that. If you need me, give me a call on the radio. My frequency is 142.52. See ya.
Disgusting.
Thank you.
What's wrong?
Do you want to save? Snake, have you ever seen On the Beach?
No, I don't know it.
It's about the survivors of the Third World War. The entire Northern Hemisphere is obliterated in a nuclear holocaust, and it's only a matter of time before the few survivors left in the Southern Hemisphere are poisoned by the deadly fallout. Their only hope is an American nuclear submarine that escapes to the Southern Hemisphere. They set out for the Arctic to investigate the fallout. The movie came out in 59, and the year that the war was supposed to happen was 1964. In other words, this year.
Nice warning. Let's hope it stays just a movie.